galaxy is far from sun.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them.
Bonus episode magic number 8. Here we go. It is Big T and Little T, and we are talking about Mandalorian Season 1, Chapter 8, the redemption, I should have pulled that up. I don't remember. So this is the season finale of Season 1, and it is directed by Taika Waititi. And this is his first one in Mandalorian, I believe. And it's top to bottom fantastic. I mean, we have some humor up front with the biker scouts. They can't hit anything, and all of a sudden IG-11 shows up and takes them out. And you know, we got Grief and Kara and Mando are held up still at the bar, and we got IG-11 coming to rescue with Baby Yoda just giggling. And I mean, IG-11 just takes out everybody and helps them kind of they escape, but then Moff is you know, doesn't mess around and blows up the E-Web battery that kind of takes out Mando pretty badly after he got off the E-Web. And yeah, it's just a lot of destruction. And then Moff's like, burn him out, and they burn him out. And but then Baby Yoda comes back and does a force pushback and force shield and lots of force stuff and takes out the incendiary trooper, gives him more time. IG-11 gets him to the sewers. They find the Mando alcove. The armor is still there. They got wiped out by, it seems like the Imperial. I believe it's the Imperials. She's melting down their armor. She's the only one left. She has time to make him a signet, which is a mud horn, which they originally talked about a couple episodes or a couple chapters ago. She puts him on them, and then she's got one more gift. Oh, yeah, jetpack. And so he gets a jetpack. Then the armor takes out a bunch of stormtroopers. Fantastic. I know from WSTR things, that's Lauren Mary Kim. She's a stunt woman. And she just rocks out that scene. It's fantastic. Takes out a bunch of stormies. And then now they're trying to escape in the sewers of Navarro. And it's going, they find a basically like a little lava boat thing, and then it's kind of sealed to the side, but then Kara kind of blasts it up, and then they get in there, and it's like this astromech with legs and arms, and he's a kind of like a, it's kind of like a lava gondola thing, and start going like, oh, here's the end of the tunnel. And Mando does a quick scan. It's like, ooh, they're all waiting for us because they know that's an outlet for one of the things. And there's about 20 stormtroopers. IG-11's like, I got this. And he, again, we have a droid teaching us about sacrifice and humanity. And, you know, he essentially tells Mando, like, hey, this is my, you know, objective. My primary is Baby Yoda to take care of him. But if you say he will be take care of him, I can revolt, you know, like kind of revert back to my self-destruction thing. And, you know, also, again, IG-11 shows us another technicality with saving Din Djarin with... so not only do we get the name of the Mandalorian, Din Djarin from Moff Gideon, but then we get to see his face. What we're kind of wondering at the beginning, like, you know, they pick Pedro. Pedro's very charismatic actor, but it was like, how long are we going to go without seeing him? And it took to chapter 8. A little box of spray in the back of the head. Boom, 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 boom. IG-11 tells a joke. And again, the technicality is like, no human has seen Din Djarin's face. And that's how he gets away with it. He trusts the droid enough to save him. And then we fast forward to the sacrifice here. And even right before that, IG-11 tells Din Djarin that he knows that he's sad, and Din Djarin plays it off, but now he has a respect for this droid. It blows up all the stormtroopers. Now Moff Gideon's after him with a TIE fighter. Mando does this jetpack thing. He gets up there, does a little grappling hook, bada bing, bada boom, puts some sticky bombs on the TIE fighter. Blows up the wing, the TIE fighter crashes, then he lands, and then it sets up Greef and Kara are going to stay in Nevarro and kind of rebuild the Empire's, you know, the guild, the Bounty Hunter Guild. And Din Djarin's like, hey, I got to bounce. I got to take care of things. They have a little thing with the ears and love you, Yoda. See you later. And then they get back to the ship. We get a cool little part with Quill. And he does like a little memorial because he's right by the Razor Crest. Nice little nod to, again, just another epic character. Again, I say this again and again. It's like IG-11 and Ugnaught Quill kind of teaches about humanity. It's just so much fun. It's a cool little Star Wars thing. And we thought the episode's over. They do a little flyby with the IG, with the Razor Crest. And then we pan over to see the crashed TIE fighter. Jawas already on the job. Kind of see that like Force Awakens when the, you know, the scrappers are right there when anything crashes. Here, this is no different. The Jawas are all over the scrap. Like, we got to get this right now. But then something happens, and we get a little kind of spark on the TIE fighter hull. Clearly a different blade. I thought it was a Darksaber when I first saw it. I know I screamed, shut the front door, and probably stood up or something because I get excited about these things. And yes, Moff Gideon is holding the Darksaber that was built by the first Mandalorian Jedi. If you don't know that stuff, that is context in the Clone Wars. And it kind of goes all the way back to Jon Favreau and Dave when they met. And it's so cool that Previsual had that. And now Moff Gideon has that. And it's a cool blade. It's fantastic, and it's supposed to be for the person that rules Mandalore or has power over Mandalore. So the fact that Moff Gideon has it brings in a totally different complexity of the situation, but he's alive, so that means it ain't done. And then, yeah, it's just, that's it. That's the season finale, and it's just like, it's a pretty good run for 8 episodes. Again, we have a lot of story building, a lot of time setting, character development, and, you know, people are dying and, you know, there's redemption and all this stuff, all the good Star Wars things. And it just, Mandalorian just checks it off all the check marks, you know. Yeah, it's just a really well done episode. And that is, again, it's written by Jon Favreau, directed by Taika, Chapter 8, Redemption. Super fun episode. And I can't wait to dive into Season 2 tomorrow. only 9 days left to the Book of Boba Fett. Let's go. Talk to you soon. Bye.